Social protection schemes are important tools to reduce poverty and inequality. They help to prevent people and their families from falling into or remaining in poverty. They also contribute to economic growth by raising labour productivity and enhancing social stability. The Kingdom of Cambodia has one of the fastest growing economies in Asia right now, with growth averaging 6% over the last decade. The National Social Security Fund was only established in 2008. Since then, it has made great strides in extending social protection coverage to wage employees in the labour force and currently provides access to employment injury insurance, social health insurance, maternity and sickness benefits to roughly 1.5 million workers. However, 60% of all Cambodian workers are still informally employed and one out of two workers in the country is self-employed, meaning they have no legal access to the NSSF yet. In 2017, the Royal Government of Cambodia started taking proactive measures to enlarge this umbrella of protection. One of the key steps was the NSSF's decision to allow the registration of micro and small enterprises with at least one worker. This decision alone instantly made an estimated additional 3 million workers eligible for NSSF protection.
នឹងពរីកគោលដៅទៅអនាគតទៀតជាពរីកទៅរកផ្នែកក្រៅប្រព័ន្ធទេយើងនឹងពរីកគោលដៅទៅអនាគតទៀតជាពរីកទៅរកផ្នែកក្រៅប្រព័ន្ធដែលបច្ចុប្បន្នយើងកំពុងតែផ្ដល់បានមួយចំនួនហើយផ្នែកក្រៅប្រព័ន្ធដូចជាបានជំរាបបានដែរគឺ 20%
But there are still many obstacles to overcome before the system can offer protection to all of Cambodia's workers. One of the challenges is the relatively new nature of social security in the country and the resulting lack of awareness about practical procedures and overall benefits of being part of the system.
It's an issue of awareness, simply, about what the benefits of participating in the social security system are. We had a big nationwide survey last year where we asked people all over the country whether they were aware about the NSSF, or BOSOSO, as it's known in Khmer, and 9 out of 10 people knew this name, but when we asked them to list the benefits that they could get, very few people could name more than one.
The construction industry in Cambodia has traditionally provided an important entry point into the labour market for landless and unskilled workers. The recent construction boom has created many new jobs and is attracting women into the sector. This sector is much more prone to industrial accidents and injuries, with ILO estimating that 1 in 5 fatal accidents happen on a construction site. Its workers are amongst the most vulnerable to ill health and poverty in case of maternity, disease, unemployment, disability, or old age. Consequently, the construction sector has been identified by the Ministry of Labour and Vocational Training as a priority for social protection intervention.
This
sector has complex subcontracting arrangements, as individual workers tend to be engaged on a casual basis without written contracts. This makes for low and irregular incomes. In addition, many informal workers also lack personal identification and bank accounts. According to rough estimates, there are more than 240,000 domestic workers in Cambodia. The overwhelming majority of them are women. The labour law of 1997 still explicitly excludes domestic workers, and Cambodia is yet to ratify the International Labour Organization's Domestic Workers Convention 189 of 2011. And so the position of domestic workers are fragile. They are subjected to harassment and deprived of employment benefits as they are not protected by legislation.
ពួកខ្ញុំគឺនៅដូចជាកណ្ដាលទន្លេដូចជាអត់មានអ្នកណាយកចិត្តទុកដាក់ទេប៉ុន្តែអ្វីដែលនាងខ្ញុំព្រួយបារម្ភពីព្រោះថារវល់ច្រើនតែប្រាក់ចំណូលតិចអញ្ចឹងមានការព្រួយបារម្ភដែរនៅពេលដែលនាងខ្ញុំអត់មានការងារធ្វើឬក៏ចាស់ឬក៏ធ្វើអីលែងកើតមិនដឹងថាតើអាចគ្រប់គ្រងជីវភាពបានដល់របៀបណាបើរងៃ
Another sector that urged inclusion under NSSF protection is the nation's estimated 10,000 tuk-tuk operators. With Cambodia witnessing steady growth, its economic hub, Phnom Penh, is expanding fast. While this growth in commuters would otherwise be a positive thing for the tuk-tuk industry, the earnings of tuk-tuk drivers are actually steadily declining, mostly because of a five-fold increase in the number of tuk-tuks operating in Phnom Penh over the last decade. There is minimal coverage of social protection systems for the self-employed informal economy workers in Cambodia. At present, tuk-tuk drivers only have the option of registering for the government's health equity fund. But research indicates that workers with high annual medical expenses would be able to save more if they become beneficiaries of NSSF's social protection schemes, which offer more comprehensive protection, including income replacement during sickness and maternity periods.
ແຕ່ພ້ອມຄາໃຫ້ກໍມີການບ້ອງບໍ່ອົນຍັງກອດມັນຍົນຂອງການກິດປອງພີສັງຄົມມັນກອດຄ້າຈະບັງນຸກໍມີເພິສິດທິພີພន្តែລະຍະເວລາກະລອງມາໂຕຍັງໄດ້ສະມາຊິກໄດ້ກອດບານນັ້ນກອດໂດຍຈະປາປາຖ້າຄືມັນອະໄວຈະກອດຄິດນັ້ນຄືມັນໂດຍຈະອະໄວໄດ້ຍັງເຄີຍເດຄືເວສຸຍຄືນີ້ເຂົ້ານະ កូនរបស់នាងខ្ញុំនឹងគាត់នឹងខិតខំរៀនឲ្យបានខ្ពង់ខ្ពស់ព្រោះនាងខ្ញុំក៏អត់ចង់ឲ្យកូនមកធ្វើជាអ្នកធ្វើការងារផ្ទះដែរប៉ុន្តែមិនដឹងថាអាចទៅរួចដែរឬទេព្រោះថាដោយពាក្យចាស់ថាយើងអាចបកកើតកូនមកបានតែយើងមិនអាចបកកើតចិត្តគាត់បានទេអញ្ចឹងក្តីសម័យនេះវាត្រឹមតែជាការអប់រំកូនការសម័យរបស់ខ្ញុំគ្មានអីវាវែងឆ្ងាយទេចង់បានណា
There is no one solution to expanding coverage of social security to the entire population because those people that are left out right now, the informally employed workers, are very varied. And so they will need tailor-made solutions. And that's why it's important for projects like expanding social protection for informal workers done in partnership by ILO and the EU-SPS are so important to create the evidence that policymakers require to create appropriate solutions to expanding, if not immediately, gradually, these benefits that all Cambodian workers deserve.
This film was brought to you by the International Labour Organization in partnership with the Government of Finland and Flanders for the East and Central Africa Social Security Association.